beautiful morning. It's a beautiful Friday morning today, Global Church family. Let's praise the Lord. Let's worship our God. Let's lift up holy hands unto our King of Kings and Lord of Lords. For such a rich anointing is moving in this house this morning. And that's the same anointing that is moving from this altar to your altar. I'm telling you, something big. God is on its way to the people of prayer, to the people of faith. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want you to get excited this morning. We are alive and well. It is well with our souls. The Spirit of the Lord lifted us up this morning out of our bed. God opened our eyes, and now we're pushing forward. We're pushing forward. Something good is coming. Something big is coming. Something marvelous is coming. Oh, hallelujah. It's a good day. It's a great day in victory. Friday, this is the day where God is about to break us into a new realm of success. While I was praying and interceding for this prayer room, the Lord said, I'm getting ready to bring you into greater success. Greater success. Great success is coming. Greater success in your ministry. Greater success in your prayer life. Greater success with your marriage. Greater success with your children. Oh, beloved of God, something good, something good. Something big is coming. It's a good day. It's a great day. It's a day of great success. Oh, hallelujah. Glory be to God. Something big is coming, people of God. And I want you to get ready for the great move of victory. Oh, hallelujah. Do the portion of scripture this morning, because we're going to be breaking forth into new grounds. We're breaking new grounds of success. We're breaking new territories of success. I'm telling you, this is what the Lord revealed. God said, get ready to break new grounds. We are breaking new grounds of success. Something big, something big, something big is coming. Let the people of God get ready. Get ready to take new mountains. Get ready to take new territories. Get ready to take your inheritance. Atmosphere shift now. We're breaking ground. We're breaking new grounds, people of God. You better command your atmosphere to shift. We're breaking new grounds. We're breaking into a new realm of success. Let the heavens be open over your life. Let the heavens be open over your life. I shift the atmosphere over your life, over your home. I command the heavens to line up with great success over your life. I command victory. I command breakthrough. Let this day bring forth breakthrough into your life. We break open new grounds of success and we pull our breakthrough in. I command the spirit of breakthrough. Breakthrough in your life. Breakthrough in your marriage. Breakthrough with your children. Breakthrough in your prayer life. Come on, church. Pull your breakthrough. We command breakthrough this morning. Let the heavens be open over your life. I shift the atmosphere now. I shift the heavens over your life. We shift into breakthrough. We shift into the atmosphere of breakthrough. Let the heavens be open. Let the heavens be open over your life this morning. We're walking into a greater success. We're walking into a greater victory. This morning we are travailing to break open new grounds. That's the travail this morning. We are travailing to break open new territories. We're travailing this morning. I want you to get ready, because what God is getting ready to bring into your life, your mind and your spirit got to be in alignment. Your mind and your spirit got to be flowing. your mind and your spirit got to be able to receive it. Let the heavens life, let the atmosphere shift over your life, because breakthrough has come. Breakthrough has come, and it's time for the people of God to step into their new level of victory this morning. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm going to give us the portion of scripture to meditate on this morning. Joshua chapter 1. Joshua chapter 1. And we're reading from verse 8. Joshua 1 and verse 8. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. Have I not commanded thee? Be strong and of a good courage. Be not afraid, neither be dismayed, for the Lord thy God is with thee wherever thou goest. Hallelujah. So that's your portion this morning, Joshua 1 and 8. And we got verse 9 in there as well. And the Spirit of the Lord is saying this morning to get ready, because you're getting ready to break new grounds. Many of you are getting ready to cross over into new territories. It is time for the dividing of the inheritance. The hour has come where the Lord is releasing your portion. Your divine inheritance has come. There are many great things laid up in the earth for you. And the Lord is saying it's time for you to go forward. It's time for you to press in. So this morning there is a pressing in. The Lord is saying, press into my goodness. Press into my glory. Press into my worship. Press into my secret place. Press into my heart. And as you press into the heart of the Lord, you're going to begin to break open new grounds. You're going to begin to take what rightfully belongs to you. You're not even going to have to pray about it, because it already has your name. You are an heir and joint heir with Christ Jesus. And the Lord says all you have to do is press in. Go forward by faith. Be strong and very courageous. Because in this season, it is only the courageous will survive. I want you to hear that again. In this season, it's only the courageous will survive. Those that are weak, those that are shaken, those that are afraid, those that are lacking confidence, you're going to have to stay down to the bottom of the hill. And those that do know their God, they are the ones that shall rise up. They are the ones that are going to be strong and do great exploits. So the Lord is saying, it's only by faith you will be able to receive the promises. For we have entered into an hour of His human history where the faith walkers shall possess the promise. The people of faith will possess the inheritance. The people of faith will inherit the new territory. The people of faith. You see, faith is the opposite of fear, right? And so you cannot want to go forward in faith and then hold on to fear. It cannot work. So we got to drop the spirit of fear. We got to wage war against that spirit, because fear is not of God. Fear is of the devil. And so faith is of God. And so you got to lift your faith. You got to increase your faith. And the Lord is saying, have I not commanded you? Be strong. Be strong. Be strong and of a good courage. Be strong. This is the hour and this is the season where the water walkers and the mountain movers are moving in. They are breaking new grounds and they are taking what belongs to them. The Lord says, be strong and of a good courage. Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. The enemy will try to rear its ugly head, but the Lord says, So do not be afraid. Just keep going forward. Just keep going forward. Just keep going forward. You're right on time. You're right on schedule. So the Lord says, go forward. Do not be afraid of what the enemy will try to show you. Do not be afraid of the plots and the plans and the schemes of devils. The Lord says, go forward. Trust my plan for your life. Trust my will for your life, because I'm working it out in your favor. Be strong. Be strong. Be strong and of a good courage. Do not be afraid and go forward, for the Lord your God is going with you. So the Lord just wanted me to remind you, to remind the people of faith this morning, that God is with us. God is with us. Wherever we go, God is with us. And the season has come and the hour has come for the people of faith to inherit their possessions. Go forward by faith. Take what belongs to you. Life does not yield to the timid. Life does not yield to the coward. Life does not yield to the fearful. Life only yields to the bold, to the courageous, to the people that do know their God, to the people that are going forward in the spirit of the lion. The lion roars, and every other animal in the jungle must scatter when the lion roars. Now let that same spirit be upon you. Let the spirit of the lion be upon you. Go forward by faith. You gotta take hold of the horns of the altar and pull from heaven what belongs to you. Hold on to the color of life and demand from life what you want. You gotta demand from life what you know belongs to you. People of God, I'm talking to you as a woman on the front line, as a woman running in the top of the mountains, as a woman living on top. I know what I'm telling you. Life does not yield to the coward. Life does not yield to the timid. Life does not yield to the fearful. It is only those that are pushing forward is going to receive their inheritance. You got to be strong and very courageous. You got to be strong and very full of the anointing, full of favor, full of fire. You got to be full of faith. Come on, people of God. It's a day of good success. This is just the beginning of our days of good success. A new season is opening for the people of faith, and God is saying, this is the beginning of our season of good success. This is the beginning of our season. It's an entire season. We're going to experience days of good success, weeks of good success, months of good success. Oh, come on, beloved of God. We're breaking new grounds. We're not accepting defeat. We're not accepting substandard. We are not accepting limitations. We are pushing against the limitation. We're pushing against every setback, every counterattack. We're pushing back. We're pushing back. We're pushing back. Come on, people of God. Somebody's travailing this morning. Somebody's interceding. Somebody's coming into agreement. The heavens are shifting. Atmospheres are shifting. And we are pushing into our season of good success. We're not going back. We're not throwing in the towel. We're not going to be crying and weeping and wailing. If life throw you lemons, you got to learn how to make lemonade. Rise up this morning in the power of God. Rise up in the strength of God. Rise up in the victory of God and go forward. The Lord is saying, go forward. The Lord is saying, go forward. Take from life what you want. Command the heavens to be open. I command the heavens to be open over your life. I command the windows to be open. I break through the barricades. I break through the limitations. Every setback, and I pull from heaven what belongs to us. I pull in our new blessings. I pull in our new wealth. I pull down our new increases. I pull down our good success. I pull down our new vehicles. I pull down our new territories. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pull from heaven this morning. There is an anointing in the house of empowerment. Receive the empowerment of the Holy Ghost. Just as Joshua was afraid, and the Lord said, Joshua, have I not commanded you? Be strong and of a good courage. Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid of their faces. Go forward. Do not be afraid of the critics. Go forward. Do not be afraid of the evil report. Go forward. For I have already commanded you. Go forward this morning, beloved. By faith, we are moving forward. We are going forward. Oh, hallelujah. There is an anointing in this house. The Spirit of the Lord is empowering you. The Spirit of the Lord is quickening your spirit. The Spirit of the Lord is anointing you from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet as you're getting ready to walk into new realms of wealth and abundance. My God, many of you are walking in the Psalm 112 anointing. We went through the fire, we went through the flood, and now God has caused us to walk into our wealthy place. The Lord says, get ready, go forward, go forward, go forward. Let the anointing come be released upon you to go forward this morning. The Spirit of increase, let the Spirit of increase be released upon you. Go forward in the realms of the Spirit. I sound the alarm over your life. I sound the shofar this morning. I hear the blast of a shofar over the lives of the intercessors. The Spirit of the Lord is breathing over watchmen. The Spirit of the Lord is breathing over seers. There is an empowerment being released. Angels are sounding the shofar. I blast the shofar over your life this morning, and I wake you up in the realms of the Spirit. Wake up this morning. Wake up, Shane. Come on, Lystra. It's time to wake up. Come on, Rosa Gilbert. Get up, get up, get up and shake your limbs and go forward. Come on, Minister Esther, Minister Junet. It's time to press forward. It's time to go forward, forgetting those things that are behind. We are pressing forth toward the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus. It's time for your dream to live again. It's time for your dream to go to another level. It's time for wealth and riches to be in your house. Oh, hallelujah. It's time to go out and get what you want. Wealth and riches will not fall out of the sky and come into your house. You got to go out and look for it. You got to go out and see what you like. You got to go out and bring it into your home. Let the anointing be released upon your life. Let the empowerment be released upon your life. Come on, Prophetess Gems Glory. It's time for new elements in that house. It's time for new vases. It's time for new lamps. It's time for new wall pictures. The Lord is saying, it's time, it's time. There is a new level of success being released over your life this morning. The Lord is saying, go forward, go forward. We're not rolling over. We're not dumbing down the anointing. We're not dumbing down our shine. We're not dumbing down or backing up because we say, well, Jesus is coming. No, beloved, Jesus said, occupy, occupy, occupy until I come. May your hands find work to do this week. May your hands never be weary. May your hands never be idle. May your hands never be without work. The Lord says, find work. Put your hands to the plow. Occupy, occupy, occupy until I come. Occupy until I come. Put your hands to the work. Occupy until I come. It's time to go forward. It's time for the people of God to inherit their possession. It's time for the inheritance to be divided. In the mighty name of Jesus, go forward. Go forward. Receive good success. Receive the empowerment on your life to go forward. Go forward this morning. Take your portion. In life, you do not ask life. You take it. You gotta take it. The people that do know their God shall be strong and do exploits. You gotta take your possession. You gotta take your inheritance by fire and by force. The kingdom suffers violence, but the violent take it by force. Come on this morning. I'm talking to people that are ordained for success. I'm talking to watchmen that are ordained for success. I'm talking to worshipers that are ordained for good success. You gotta take by force. Take by force. Take by force your spouses. Take by force your good success. Take back your family. Take back your children. Take back your business. Take back your property. Take back your influence. Come on, people of God. You gotta take it back. You gotta take it back this morning. I know what I'm telling you. You gotta take it back. If you lay down and you're waiting for someone to feel sorry for you, it will never happen. You gotta rise up in the anointing of God and take back. Take back what belongs to you. Take back your power. Take back your anointing. Take back your favor. Take it back. Take it back. Take it back. Sata karabaka soto korobuko sata. Let the heavenly language come out of your mouth this morning as you come into agreement. Begin to intercede in agreement. The Spirit of the Lord is releasing an empowerment upon us. The Spirit of the Lord is downloading new strategies. There is a new power being released upon us this morning. Receive the power of the Lord. Receive the anointing of God upon your life. Fresh oil is being released. Fresh anointing. That's right, Prophetess Gems Glory. I am redeemed for signs and wonders. Hallelujah. My life is redeemed for signs and wonders. And I will not settle for anything less but signs and wonders. Great victory is our portion. Victory is our portion. I want you to pray in tongues right where you are. Pray in tongues just a few more minutes. And then I'm going to bring on the morning devotion. Let's pray in tongues this morning. I sense a shift in the atmosphere. The atmosphere is shifting. The heavens are shifting. Something big is coming. Something great is happening. Angels are just realigning our destinies. Angels are setting us up for a win. I hear the Lord say, get ready for a big win. Somebody's coming into a big win. It's a big win. This is your winning season. You're stepping into one of the greatest victories of your life. It's nothing that you're expecting. It's nothing that you thought was coming. It's just a big win. Because the atmosphere has shifted now. The heavens have shifted. The heavens is now in alignment with the mind of God and the will of God concerning the season. It's a season of good success. And so good success has to be birthed. Good success has to be birthed. I stand as a midwife this morning and I shift the heavens over my life. I command the womb of heaven to bring forth the success that belongs to us. I command the womb of heaven to bring forth the victories that belong to us. I stand as a midwife, rubbing the womb of heaven, and I command the womb to give up the victories. Give up the victory. Give up the good success. Release it into our lives. Let good success rain down. Let good success flow over our lives. A big win, a big win. God is releasing a big win. It's our winning season. And you're about to win in life. You're about to win in this season. Does not matter what the enemy tried to show you. It does not matter the enemy's report. Whose report will you believe? We believe the Lord's report. The Lord says it's your winning season. You're coming into a big win. People are going to wonder, how did you get that? How did that happen to her? How did that victory come to her life? But the Lord says, fear not, worry not, because heaven has birthed out this morning. The atmosphere has shifted over your life this morning. And you're coming into a win, a big win. It's your winning season. The devil wanted to see you down and out crying and grieving because of a bad report. But the Lord says, what the devil meant for evil, I'm turning it into good. It's your winning season. What you confess, you shall possess. So you don't have to depend on your present circumstance to declare and confess winning season. You gotta confess your winning season by faith. It's your winning season. You're gonna win in this thing called life. You're going to win in your family. You're going to win in your marriage. Many of you, you're going to win over the affection of your spouses. Just like that, it's going to happen. Just like that, you're going to win over the affection of your spouses. It's your winning season. Kasumro sotokosata. It's your winning season. The people that matter the most to you, you're going to win over favor with them. It's your winning season. Your season of winning have come. You are winning. You are winning in this thing called life. You are winning. You are anointed to win. We are anointed to win. This is the day. Good success shall be made manifest over your life. Good success. I declare it, I announce it, I legislate it, and so shall it be. Good success have come into our lives this morning. It cannot be denied. It cannot be denied, beloved. We are creating our life. We are creating our season of success. Good success. Good success. We have spoken it, we have ordered it, we have legislated it, and so shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus. That's right, Pastor Cheryl. It's my winning season, and I will take it no other way. It's my winning season. I want to give you a song. It's time to praise your God. Everything is coming in double. The blessing is coming in double. Your wealth is coming in double. Greater wealth for a greater glory is coming. You better receive it.
In the morning when I wake up,
let's go.
I will sing my praise unto you, my Lord.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And I will shout and dance to you.
Yeah.
For you have been my help from now to never. Tell you who has
the final say.
to act outwardly on what you see inwardly? Or will you die dreamer? Will you die on the verge and on the edge and in the land of coulda, woulda, and shoulda? The strong hand rules the roost. Do you have the courage? I'm going to drop something on you. It takes courage to be successful. It is far easier not to be successful. Misery will always have company. Success breeds contempt. If you don't want to make waves, be mediocre. Be normal and fit in. And if you're more concerned about people than you are God, then neutralize everything he put in you. Just fit in with everybody else. Dress like them, walk like them, act like them, eat like them, go where they go, think like they think, do what they do. And once you've neutralized your meekness, you don't need courage. It takes courage to be different. It takes courage to go where you've never gone before. For some of you, it took courage to come to this conference. It takes courage to get you outside of the box. It takes courage to be successful. It takes courage to win. People don't talk about people that don't win. If you win, they're going to talk about you. Do you have the courage to stand there till the storms keep raging and the people get to talking and you stand there and say, I've come too far to turn around? That's your girlfriend and say, do you have the courage? I'm gonna say something to you. It takes courage to be exceptional. It takes courage to be wise. It takes courage to be rich. It takes courage to be educated. It takes courage to be knowledgeable. Because the moment you do, but you don't talk like you, oh, you done forgot where you came from. Look at you, talking. It takes courage. And I'm just wondering, in this weak, watered down, mediocre society that we live in today, in this reality TV world we live in today, I'm wondering if there's anybody left that's got the courage to say, after all I've been through, and all my ancestors have been through, and all my parents have been through, I didn't come through all of that just to fit in with normalcy. I have the courage to go after my dream.
I learned from my mistakes. In other words, my instinct is, you go there and you place a bet. And I've had losers. And what I did, every time I made a mistake, they became painful mistakes. But with time, I realized that reflecting on those mistakes would give me gems. What I would do is I'd say, why did I make that mistake? And I would learn from that mistake. And I'd write down a rule. So what was helpful for me is I put that rule, these principles down. Those principles that I wrote down, I then put into algorithms, in other words, equations. And what I learned by being able to do that is if I took my decision criteria, those principles, and then I tested them back through time, I gained a perspective that was fantastic.
10 years from now, you're going to arrive. The question is where. And if you don't do something today, you're going to show up somewhere. So what happens is, when you go through the natural disappointments and frustrations, when it doesn't work out the way you expected, when people betray you or disappoint you or hurt you, what happens is, all cynicism is, all skepticism is a protective device that says, I don't want to get my hopes up because I don't want to feel that drop of disappointment. I don't want to feel the loss. I don't want to feel the hurt. So when people tell me I'm cynical, I'm pessimistic, I look at them and say, listen, let's be honest. You're gutless. It doesn't take any courage to think things don't work and they're wrong and they're terrible and never fixed, because you'll never be disappointed, because you'll never take any action, so it won't change and it's self-fulfilling. But it takes guts to say, I'm going to believe in something and try it, even though I might fail the first, fourth, tenth time, I'm going to keep going. And I believe that most human beings, that they put themselves on the line, they would uncover who they really are. But most of us are so afraid of failing or not looking good or losing out that we just never discover who we are. What I think we have in common is we're willing to step into the uncertainty. All passion is found in the realm of uncertainty. And yet human beings are pulled to certainty because we don't want to deal with our fears. freedom, liberation is when you break through the fears. All of my brethren out there, all my brothers and sisters watching who are entrepreneurs or considering being entrepreneurs, you are what I'm made for. I mean, I've built 18 companies, 12 I actively manage, $5 billion in sales, as I told you, 1,200 employees. It blows my mind. I have no business background, but I have this passion that says I must do more for others than anybody else, and I'll never stop growing, and I'll never stop changing, and I'll never stop improving, and I feel alive by doing that, as opposed to let me do the same thing every day because I'm good at it, and let me continue to do that, and hopefully my life is really good. That'll make you feel, you know, feel numb, if not depressed or frustrated or overwhelmed, which is where beings live.
Anything that you're going through right now, if you want to take a big scary leap and you want to start a new career or perhaps start a business, anything that you might consider a failure is really just a necessary step on your journey to success. So no matter what you're facing right now, no matter what's getting you so scared, there's only one question that you need to ask and answer to find the courage to make that big leap. And the question is this: what's the worst thing that can happen? So not just by saying yes, but what's the worst thing that could happen if you said no? So for example, a few years ago, I asked my really dear friend Laura to come speak at one of our live events. Now this was a big opportunity for her, but I know it was kind of stressful. And I said, you know what? This is big, so take a few days, think about it, because once you say yes, you're gonna be locked in. So first she had to ask herself, well, what's the worst thing that could happen if So for her, it was the stress, it was wishing that she never committed, which she wished she never committed, but it was also this fear that she was gonna completely freeze up on stage, that she was gonna mess up horribly and completely ruin her reputation, which she did not. Now on the flip side, she had to ask herself, what's the worst thing that could happen if she said no? So you gotta get that Laura really wanted to grow her business and her brand. And if she said no to this opportunity, she'd have to face herself in the mirror every single day and say, nice going, bonehead. You had the perfect opportunity to grow your business and you turned it down. So now it's your turn. I want you to ask yourself, what's the worst possible thing that could happen if you said yes and you'd fail miserably? So don't just think about this loosely. I want you to get really specific and tease out every single scenario that could possibly go wrong and how you deal with it if it did. What most of us discover is that no matter what the worst case scenario is, we can actually handle it. But don't forget, you gotta go on the flip side too and ask yourself, what's the worst thing that could happen if you decide to do nothing and keep your life exactly as it is? Are your regrets gonna start to pile up like pancakes? Are you gonna turn into some miserable, self-loathing sad sack? I really want you to tease this one out and get all the scenarios on the table and then take a look. What do you got? What's the worst of the worst? Going for it? Or not going for it?
You tried to get into 3 colleges. Mm-hmm. Each time they rejected you.
No, I tried. There's an examination that young people, if you want to go university, you have to take the examinations. So I failed 3 times. But a lot of fail. I failed for funny things that I failed a key primary school test for 2 times. And I failed 3 times for the middle schools, and you would never believe in Hangzhou, my city, there's only 1 middle school that lasts only 1 year. It was changed from primary school to middle school because our graduates of our school, no middle school accept us because we're too bad. They would become a middle school.
What effect did it have, though, being rejected?
Well, I think we have to get used to it. We're not that good. Even today, we still have a lot of people reject us. I think when I graduate from universities, and before I, you know, for 3 years I tried to fill in the universities. So I applied jobs for 30 times, got rejected. I went for a police. They said, no, you're not good. I went to even the KFC. When KFC came to China, come to my city, 24 people went for the job. Yeah. 23 people accepted. I was the only one guy. And we went for police. Five people, four of them accepted. I was the only guy that I received it. So to me, being turned down, rejected. Oh, by the way, I told you that I applied for Harvard for 10 times rejected. I know I'll be rejected.
Sorry,
I just
now.
Want to
see sorry now. Sorry
right.
now. 10 times you wrote them and said, I'd like to come to Harvard.
Yeah. And then I told myself, someday I should go teach there, baby.
Do you have the courage to act outwardly on what you see inwardly? Or will you die a dreamer? Will you die on the verge and on the edge and in the land of coulda, woulda, and shoulda? The strong hand rules the roost. Do you have the courage? I'm going to drop something on you. It takes courage to be successful. It is far more successful. Misery will always have company. Success breeds contempt. If you don't want to make waves, be mediocre. Be normal and fit in. And if you're more concerned about people than you are God, then neutralize everything he put in you. Just fit in with everybody else. Dress like them, walk like them, act like them, eat like them, go where they go, think like they think, do what they do. And once you've neutralized your uniqueness, you don't need courage. It takes courage to be different. It takes courage to go where you've never gone before. For some of you, it took courage to come to this conference. It takes courage to get you outside of the box. It takes courage to be successful. It takes courage to win. People don't talk about people that don't win. If you win, they're going to talk about you. Do you have the courage to stand there till the storms keep raging and the people get to talking and you stand there and say, I've come too far to turn around? Touch your girlfriend and say, do you have the courage? I'm gonna say something to you. It takes courage to be exceptional. It takes courage to be wise. It takes courage to be rich. It takes courage to be educated. It takes courage to be knowledgeable. Because the moment you do, but you don't talk like you, oh, you don't got forgot where you came from. Look at you talking. It takes courage. And I'm just wondering, in this weak, watered down, mediocre society that we live in today, in this reality TV world we live in today, I'm wondering if there's anybody left that's got the courage to say, after all I've been through, and all my ancestors have been through, and all my parents have been through, I didn't come through all of that just to fit in with normalcy. I have the courage to go after my dream.
I learned from my
So thank you for praying with us this morning. Thank you for worshiping. Thank you for receiving the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Now you go out today and have a great day of success. This is Apostle Anna Edwards saying, may the Lord bless you, may the Lord keep you, and may the Lord shine you with the oil of victory. Expect a great day of success. See you on this evening at 6 p.m. Shalom.